فويل يومئذ للمكذبين.
So, woe to those who reject the true faith.
الذين هم في خوض يلعبون.
Who are indulged in vain talk, playing with truth.
يوم يدعون إلى نار جهنم دعا.
The day they will be pushed to the fire forcefully.
هذه النار التي كنتم بها تكذبون.
And it will be said to them, this is the fire you used to deny.
أفسحر هذا أم أنتم لا تبصرون.
Is it then magic, or do you not see?
اصلوها فاصبروا أو لا تصبروا سواء عليكم إنما تجزون ما كنتم تعملون.
Enter it. Now, whether you endure it patiently or impatiently, it is all the same for you. You are merely rewarded for what you used to do.
So verse number 11 through 16, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing the disbeliever and what will happen to them at that day when the trumpet will be blown and the day of judgment will be established. Important thing is Quran, as we see, always when it talks about the people of hellfire, it talks next about the people of paradise, the people of punishment, after followed or led by verses about the people of reward. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, woe to those people who deny the truth, the faith, and the message of Allah and His Messenger Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says, الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي خَوْدٍ يَلْعَبُونَ. These are the ones who are indulging in vain talks and playing with the truth. يَلْعَبُونَ. لَعَب means play. So they are playing with the word. They are playing and joking around it. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي خَوْدٍ. These are the ones who are into the خَوْد, is the vain things. And many of the times people are involved in those things which are considered useless. Those are just considered wasting time. If we see the truthfully, again, it's, I don't want to be kind of OCD about it. The fact is that every moment passed by is a history and future is a mystery. 5 minutes ago before we start the program, and it was a past. It's not going to come back. In future, we don't know what it holds for us, whether we'll be here or not. The beautiful thing is, we should live in past. And the wise man says, when you are living in present, you are almost in peace. So whatever we have, we should accept it. And that is what is for the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we should think about the future, but we should not worry about future, because that gives us anxiety. Anxiety is a fear of unknown. And this is what is the anxiety about. Our mind should be controlled. And Quran gives us that message. Live in present. According to some scholars, that the moment is only moment to moment. Present is the moment. So enjoy the moment. Do not let go waste of the moment, because the moment wasted is not coming back, and every moment will be counted in the day of judgment. So people who are indulged in vain talk or playing it with the truth, they are going to be in trouble. يَوْمَ يُدْعَوْنَ إِلَى النَّارِ جَهْنَّمَ دَعَى. The day they will be pushed, دَعَى, to the fire of hell forcefully. They will be driven there to the fire. As we heard in the other chapters, how harsh and three type of smokes will be coming, and hell will be coming, and the hell or the Jahannam, what is known in the Quran. There are seven level of Jahannam, and each one of them will be asking Allah, oh Allah, give more. Is there more? هَذِهِ النَّارُ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ بِهَا تُكَذِبُونَ. This is the fire. They will, and it will be said that this is the fire to them, that this is the fire you used to deny. This is the fire. Allati kuntum, that the one you were, you have been. Kuntum in the past tense. Biha tukadhibun, about which you used to deny that there is no fire. This is just fear tactics for the nauzubillah for Prophet. Afa sihrun haza am antum la tubsirun. And it is a magic, and do you not to get to see it? So these are the one this being told for these people. Islawha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, then they will be, Islawha, enter. Islah means something which come in front of you, like the hellfire will come on the face to face. Salah is also known as the fire or the shield coming in front. Islaha fa asbiru. So be patient now. Wala tubsiru, or be impatient, it will not matter. Sawa'un alaykum, it is equal for you. Innama tujzawna bima kuntum ta'amalun. This is the jaza. Innama, indeed, this is tajzawna, ta mean you, jazawna, for you all, those who are in the hellfire, reward or return of. Ma kuntum ta'amalun, whatever you used to do, which is that denying Allah and disobeying Prophet and doing the bad things, the evil which Allah has forbidden, those actions being done by those people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, this is the reward of what you used to do, and the jaza is the return of what you used to do. So it is just nothing, it's merely for what you earn. And that is the reward of your earning, because you think that God and message is false and no truth to it. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the people of paradise. What will they be getting and what will be their situation? As we say, 50,000 days, years long will be a day. And that is the day of judgment. And that is the day of believers. But it will be moment, and it will be felt like moment upon them, because they will not be seeing the horror of the day of judgment. And this is the difference between disbeliever and believer.
إن المتقين في جنات ونعيم.
Of course, the God-fearing will be in gardens and bliss.
فاكهين بما آتاهم ربهم ووقاهم ربهم عذاب الجحيم.
Enjoying what their Lord will have given to them, and their Lord will have saved them from the punishment of hell.
كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا هَنِيئًا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ.
It will be said to them, eat and drink pleasantly because of what you used to do.
مُتَّكِئِينَ عَلَى سُرُرٍ مَصْفُوفَةٍ وَزَوَّجْنَاهُمْ بِحُورٍ عِينٍ.
Relaxing on lined-up couches. And we will marry them with big-eyed houris.
Verse number 17 to 20 is talking about إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ. Now the returns of those who will be the believers and those who obey Allah and His Messenger, live as the God of command, God has commanded, they will be in the paradise, in the gardens. Jannat means garden. And also Jannah means hidden, the hidden gardens. Why? Like Jannat, the jinns, which are hidden from human eyes. So those which are hidden from our eyes are known as Jannah. Jannat is the Jannat. There are seven level of Jannah, and there will be highest. And above that is the throne of Allah. So I have mentioned before the seven level of the Jannah. Inshallah, I will mention it in my next time. I didn't bring it up at this time. Inshallah, we'll discuss that. There are seven level of paradise and seven level of hellfire. And the hypocrites will be in the bottom of it. Once the hadith of Prophet, Jibreel came, and the angel Jibreel al-Islam came to Prophet, and he looked sad. The Prophet said, what's going on, Jibreel? Why you are not happy, or why you are so sad? He said, O Messenger of Allah, I saw that your nation, your believers in your nation will be in the hell. Prophet says, what do you mean? He says, well, they will be also going to hell. So Prophet asked him further, and he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have decreed that your nation people who will not obey the commands of Allah will be there, and they will be in the lightest of the hell. But that lightest of the hell is the 70 times more harsh for the what we know in the world. It will be so harmful. Those who will be those? They will be the one who are believer, but they have committed sin. Till their punishment is over, so they will be in the level of Jahannam, but they will be in the lightest, the lowest Jahannam, which is the one of the seven. And the hypocrites will be in the seventh, which is the worst and harshest of all the things. So hypocrisy is not loved by Allah. And second level, there will be, I think, Christian. The third level will be the Jews, and that will be different kind of people will be going in different level of hell, which is, again, disbelievers and disobedient to God's command. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is here, is taking, indeed, the muttaqeen will will be depending, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enter everybody into paradise by his free will, and then the level of the paradise will be according to their good deeds. So this is why a scholar says, do not let go of a minor good deed as nothing, and do not do a smaller sin because of nothing. Everything will bring you, come with you to the day of judgment and bring a person to the hell or heaven. فَكِهِنَ بِمَا أَتَاهُمْ رَبِّهِمْ. They will be enjoying and they'll be laughing and celebrating from what their Lord has أَتَاهُمْ, given to them by their Lord. وَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ عَذَابَ الْجَهِيمِ. And their Lord will have saved them. وَقَاهُمْ, punishment of hellfire. So when Muslims who will be in the hellfire, those who will be going, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the day of judgment, we have talked about this hadith many times, he will be given this option that day, and he will go into the prostration and will ask, this is long hadith, I will again mention, because this is something which we have talked about before, that humanity will be gathered, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be in the Jalal, nobody can speak to him, humanity will run to Adam. Adam alayhi salam, they will think that he is the father of the humanity, he will ask for forgiveness to Allah, they will ask him, and he will say, nafsi nafsi, izhab ila ghair, that today I am worried about myself, I disobeyed Allah's command, I cannot, I am worried about myself, so go to another prophet. Then they will run to Nuh alayhi salam. The Nuh alayhi salam, he will say, I punish a curse for my nation, I cannot ask Allah's mercy, go to somebody else. They will come to Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam will say, they will say, oh Ibrahim, you are the friend of Allah, you are Khalilullah, you should intercede on our behalf to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will say, and it's nafsi nafsi, today I cannot do anything, I'm afraid of my own self because I lied once, even though it was not a lie in a way, but it was say I said what I was not supposed to say, and that's why I cannot stand in front of Allah. This is a hadith, not that I'm making up. Then they will be going further, looking down to Musa alayhi salam. Musa alayhi salam will say, I showed anger against my nation, and today I cannot ask Allah for mercy, and go to next. They will come to Jesus, Isa alayhi salam, son of Mary, and they will ask him, and Jesus will say, today nobody can stand in front of Allah. Only one who can go, you can go to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he will say, ana laha, ana laha, come to me, I will take, and people will bring their sin to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he will take their sin, and then he will, he said in another hadith, he said, every prophet had a supplication he was supposed to ask, and I saved my supplication for the day of judgment, and that day I'm going to ask for the forgiveness of my nation. So that time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him, station him at the Muqam Mahmud, the station of worshipping and praiseworthiness. And Prophet says, that day I will be taught a special prayer, a special dua, supplication, and I will go into prostration and will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy, and I recite that, and then I will go into the prostration. After saying the praises of God, he will do the prostration, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, irfa ra'sak ya Muhammad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, will raise his head, and that then Allah will ask what you want. He will say, ya Rab, habli ummati, my Lord, my ummat, my nation, forgive them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, okay, go to the jahil and take out one third of them. Prophet describes, he will take them out like in two hands, and they will be brought out. And then he will go back into same prostration, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask him to raise your head again, and he will be told to go and take out another one third of it. So two third will be taken out. Then he will do third time same thing. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send him to bring out all of them. And there will be last third will be brought out from the hellfire with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Prophet says, Shafa'ati li ahlil kaba'ir fi ummati. My intercedence is for the people who are the major sinner among my nation. And this is where he says, Prophet says, you see, Prophet is a mercy for all the creation. Why? You say little word and major benefit happen. A major sin is wiped out. A major wrongdoing is gone away. A minor is wiped out. He said, say astaghfar all the time. If you say astaghfar, whatever you did wrong, he said, do a good. So you can balance those deeds out. So in the day of judgment, those deeds which we're thinking or ignoring as little will be valuable. In this month of Rabiul Awwal, say salawat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. 10 sins will be wiped out. 10 good deeds will be written account. 10 salutation will be coming from Allah. 10 salutation will be coming from angels. And 10 deeds will be added into your account. 50 benefit for one salawat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it's easy. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just say this much word and it will get you both the shahada and as well as the benefit of that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that that day they will be eating fruits and they will be celebrating and Allah will have saved them from the hellfire. And this is where kulu washrabu haniyan bima kuntum ta'amaloon. So eat and celebrate and enjoy pleasantly for that what you used to do. You see, the Jannah's level and celebration is from the amal. First is the belief or creed, and second is the deeds. So deeds come after that. Muttaqina ala sururhim. They will be laying on the couches on the back. You know, there's a pillow and taqiyah, what we call the gau taqiyah in Urdu, where people are laying and this is the throne. Masfufatan wa azwajuhum bihurin ayn. And they will be married them with the big-eyed huris. Huris are a creature of a female described. The men will be married to them and women will be married to their husbands. Those who are wives in the world will be the wives in the paradise, and they will be the leaders or the queens in the sense of each family, and they will be more beautiful than all the other huris together. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them beautiful. Men will be made beautiful, and these 70 wives in the world will be married. This has been according to one of the hadith, and no matter what that it is, symbolic or metaphor, we do not know. We believe in the words of it. Some scholars say these are just for the explanation, and then there will be also servants. There will be servants, and according to some of the details, no, there will be women, men will be married to them, and their wives in the world will be the leader or chief of all those other wives which will be married, and nobody have seen them. And they are supposedly so beautiful that if they spit on the ocean, the ocean will turn sweet. They will be so miraculous creature or woman which Allah has created, and they are there for the promising. Because, you know, a man is always lustful about having wives or children, the greed about having more. So this is the promises given to them by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's listen to the verse number 21.
والذين آمنوا واتبعتهم ذريتهم بإيمان ألحقنا بهم ذريتهم وما ألتناهم من عملهم من شيء كل امرئ بما كسب رهين.
And those who believed and their children followed them in belief, we will join their children with them, and will not curtail the reward of any of their deeds at all. Every person will be pledged for what he earned.
Verse number 21, little explanation. The scholar says this verse means those who believe and their children and the grandchildren of the four or the generation to come follow them in the belief of the Allah and His Messenger. Al-haqna bihim. Allah says we will join them together. Zurriyatuhum, their children. Wama alatnahum min amalihim. And we will not curtail any reward of them. Alatnahum. Nahum. They will not be denied. Min amalihim, from the deeds and the actions they have done. Min shayin, anything what they did good. And every soul is ransomed to its deeds and action what they had earned. This word needs more explanation in the sense that it is being said by scholars that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be merciful, and those people who are in paradise, when they will not find their loved ones, they will ask, Lord, where is our this loved ones? And one of them is in the higher and all of them will be in the lower, or all of them in the higher and one of them will be in the lower paradise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not bring the higher to the lower level. Allah ta'ala actually will give the lower one the heaven of the higher level and bring the one who's from the low Jannah paradise to the higher paradise as the reward and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that date. This is something very beautiful thing to understand if we could comprehend.